Hello watch fans, it's Anders here on Watch On channel. Today I'm back with another Spinnaker. This is a brand new Spinnaker, or a new version of a well-known Spinnaker. It's the Cahill. But this time they actually decided to downsize the watches. So last time I reviewed a Spinnaker watch, it was a huge, big, masculine diver, the DUMAS. And this is a huge watch, as you can see, pretty much a big difference. If you're interested in this watch, you can click on the link up in the right hand corner to see the review, or down in the description. Both of these watches you can have for 15% off if you use the code WATCHON15. Then you save 15% of the price, and that's approximately $50, so it's worth taking the discount. You can find the link and the code down below in the description as well. But today, the newest watch from the lineup, this time they decided to downsize the Cahill watch, which is a well-known model in their collection, and they actually decided to downsize it to just approximately 40 millimeters, so you get a much more vintage size. It's 39 and a half to 40 millimeters, including the crown, approximately 43 and a half, thickness of 13 millimeters, a lug width here of 20, so you can change between straps if you don't like the factory bracelet, and then we get a lock to lock of approximately 46. So these are very classic dimensions in my opinion. This watch comes in three different versions: a black version, the blue version I have here, and an all blacked out version with a PVD coating on the case, so you get a completely blackened out watch. Very shortly about the packaging: typical Spinnaker cardboard box. Inside you have a pillow, and then you get a fiber cloth, a little information, and a hang tag and stuff like that. So nothing too special, but it's all about the watch, not the packaging. So the specific reference number for this Cahill from Spinnaker is SP-5075-22. So let's get into the watch. What we get is a 150 meter dive watch. It's water resistant down to 150 meters. It's blue with this grainy texture dial, as you can see, and this really makes a big difference regarding the legibility. Because of the grainy dial, you don't get the glossy look of the dial, and then you don't get the light back when you're trying to read the watch. So that's absolutely a good idea from Spinnaker. It has this very nice kind of dark blue color, and that's the same with the glass bezel inlay. I believe this is mineral crystal, so sapphire crystal on the top and also sapphire crystal on the back. I will be getting back to the movement just in a few seconds. Big applied hour markings, which are filled with loom. This is a loom monster, as we know from Spinnaker. And if you're a guy who's into very luminous watches, this is definitely a watch to have a look at. Spinnaker 12 o'clock, automatic, the water resistance of 150 meters down here. At 6 o'clock, at 3 o'clock, a date window, and then we have these Rolex-inspired Mercedes hands. Usually I'm not very fond about these Mercedes hands on other watches than Rolex, but on this watch I think it actually really works. The bezel is a little bit hard to grip because of the coin etching, but it's absolutely good. And it's very, very nice action. You don't get any play. And the great thing is that you get a 120-click unidirectional bezel on this Spinnaker Cahill. So a very nice bezel action, in my opinion. A thing I'm a big fan of with this watch is definitely the orange lollipop second hand. I think it looks absolutely great with this kind of cream-colored luminous material. And it looks great with the blue colors. And then you also get the pop of orange with the water resistance riding at 6 o'clock. So I really like the sportiness and the fresh color of this watch. But if you're more into a black version, then you can also find that one, as I said. So stainless steel case brushed on the sides of the case. And on the chamfering here, you get polishing. It comes in this very nice H-link bracelet with tapers. It's a high quality bracelet, solid links, solid end links. The clasp is absolutely okay. It's a fold over, and then you get a push button release, stamped metal, not milled metal, three micro adjustments, so you can easily adjust to the size you want. You get a unprotected crown, which is signed with the Spinnaker seal here. And it's very easy to operate. It's a screw down crown. It pops very nicely. As you can see, the movement isn't hacking, but it's manually windable, which is absolutely the most important thing. So very easy to screw back in, and a very nice crown. The knurling on the crown makes it very, very easy to grip. Looking at the case back here, as you can see, we get a customary Spinnaker rotor. This is a Miyota 8215. I believe it's that movement because that's a movement Spinnaker has used before. And it's absolutely a reliable movement, very easy to service, but it isn't the most interesting movement. And as you can see here, it's very unexciting to look at. Of course, it's always nice to be able to see the movement through the see-through case back, which is of course also sapphire as on the front, but it is a very unexciting movement. So nothing too special with this movement, in my opinion. On the wrist, and I have an 18 centimeter wrist in circumference, this watch wears absolutely amazing. I really, really think this watch is the best Spinnaker watch I have tried so far. It's not the watch with the best movement. They do use some Seiko NH35 movements in a lot of other watches, also in the DUMAS I just showed you. And that is a bit better movement than this Miyota, which is from Citizen, because it has hacking. But all in all, when you look at the bracelet, the design, the wear comfortability of this watch, I definitely think this is so far the best Spinnaker I have tried, and I believe I'm up to 7 or 8 different Spinnaker watches. And full disclosure, this was sent from Spinnaker to me for review. I get to keep the watch, but it doesn't affect my review. Just trust me, I give you my honest opinion. And of course, also an honest opinion regarding this watch being less than $300 US. And of course, I'm not comparing this to Rolex quality or anything like that. When you compare this watch to Citizen and a lot of micro brands, and of course also the more affordable Seiko divers, I think you get a much better package. Everything aligns, everything is better thought out, and it wears very, very nicely at just below 40 millimeters. So all in all, a very nice watch. My biggest gripe with this watch is definitely that they didn't use a better movement. I would have preferred the Seiko NH35, and that is kind of a letdown with this watch, that they didn't use a better movement. This is a very reliable and easy serviceable movement, no problem with the movement. I would have enjoyed to have the hacking function, and I would be perfectly okay spending $20 or $25 more on this watch if they also supplied a better movement. But again, overall, a very nice package, definitely the best Spinnaker in my opinion so far when we count in everything, and especially the design and how nice it is to wear this watch. So this was my review of the brand new Spinnaker Cahill, the new version, the smaller version. They made a good choice of making this watch a little smaller and getting into the trend of more wearable watches, in my opinion. If you enjoyed this review, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Leave a comment down below. What do you think about this watch? Is it worth the approximately $300 if you use the discount code? Also, don't forget to follow me on Instagram and Facebook, and I will be back with much more watch content very soon. Thank you. Bye.